Hi everyone, this is Palak from Ignited Minds. There's a question in my mind that I wanted to ask from all of you. How many of you actually fear the numbers? How many of you actually are scared of mathematics as a subject? I believe students have problem mostly in mathematics. So today I'm going to tell you some tricks that are part of Vedic mathematics that are surely going to help you when it comes to solving the equations or problem. So let's get started. So now let's start with trick number one. So this Vedic mathematic tricks help you when you're given a number that has to be divisible or divided by 5. For example, the number is x. X can be any number and it has to be divided by 5. So traditional method usually takes more of time. I'm going to tell you one simple trick that will take only seconds for you to solve. Now let us take one example as 16. Alright, and it has to be divided by 5. So now I'll show you the traditional method first. You will write 5 here, 5 into 3, 15, then you will get 1, then you will use decimal here, then you will use 0, 2, 10. So what do you get here? 3.2. Alright, I have a shorter method than this. What you will do is, you have to simply multiply the numerator. This is numerator, this is denominator. Multiply it by 2, 16 into 2, 32. Now you have denominator which is a 1 digit, so put one decimal before it. You don't even have to solve this much. Only you can solve 16 by 5 is 3.2. Take another example for your convenience, 17 by 5. Same process you will apply, 17 into 2 is 34. And this is a one digit place, so put one it here, simply. So now you got the answers clearly. When a number is divisible by 5, you can perform this, but in competitive examinations, when you have a lot of questions, I believe you should know these tricks. So the first trick was, when any number is divided by 5, you just have to multiply it by 2. Now, as we have already learned about 5, let us start about 25. Suppose if the number has to be divided by 25. So you will do nothing except adding one more 2. How? Suppose the question is 16 divided by 25. Now what you will do? You will multiply 2 into 2, which is equals to 4. So you will simply write here 16 into 4 by 25. Now you can find out the answer. 64 by 25. Now you see here there are 2 digits. So initially when I told you when there was 1 digit, the decimal has to be put before 1. Now since it is 2, so the answer will be 0.64. As simple as that. Now let us use the another number, that is 44. Now again, as I told you, if this is the question, so what you will do? You will simply multiply 2 into 2. That is 44 into 4 by 25. It is 176. Now what do you see? There are 2 numbers. So you will put digit here. You will put the decimal here. So the answer is 1.76. Now if you start solving it by traditional method, you see you will put 0 and so long step will it take, and there are particularly more chances of being a mistake because you can subtract it wrong, you can add it wrong, you can put the decimal wrong. So why do you do that? When you simply have a short trick. Now let us consider another trick, which is trick number 3. Up till now we have learned how to solve numbers that have to be divided by 5, 25. Now let us come to 125. What was the process here? Multiply by 2. What was the process here? Multiply into 4. Now you are smart enough to understand what will be the process here? Multiply by 8. As simple as that. So you can write it like this also, or you can simply write like this. So 8 into 4 is 32 by 125. Now again, something very important for you. Here we have 3 digits. Here we have 2 digits. So what we will do? We will make it 3 and put a point here and 0 here. Of course, we cannot leave the LHS blank. So the answer will be 0.032. Simple. Now imagine if you have to divide it with the traditional method, it will create an utter confusion. So it's better for you, divide it by 8. Make the digit equal to the denominator in case it is less, and then you put a decimal here. Now let us get back to another digit, another trick, that is multiplication of 2 digit numbers. Now I want all of you to take care of this. You can see 2 numbers here, one is 48 and the other is 50. Make it 53 or 52. Okay, don't make it 50, make it 52. Now if you can see, both the numbers are close to 50. They are almost close. So you can write this number as 50 minus 2. You can write this number as 50 plus 2. Now I want all of you to know about one property. A square minus b square equals to a plus b, a minus b. This is a property. If you have any digit in this form, you can expand it into a plus b and a minus b. Now, can you see something similar to this? 50 minus 2, a minus b, 50 plus 2, a plus b. So it is clear from the example that a is 50, b is 2. So we will put these two into this format. That means 50 square minus 2 square. I hope it is clear. I told you a plus b, a minus b, it can be written as a square minus b square. Both are same. You can either write like this or you can write like this. So when it is already mentioned like this, we will put it as 50 square minus 2 square. Now the calculation is pretty simple. 50 square is 2500 minus 4. So you will write here as 2496 is the answer. Now this 48 into 52, within 2 seconds you have come to the conclusion that this is the answer. So this is how you multiply two digits. You have to find the nearest number, which is almost 50, because it is close. So it can be written as 50 minus 2. This can be written as 50 plus 2. Then you can follow this property and easily you can find out the answer. Now you must say that it's a long method, but just see why I used 50 here, because it's a simple way to perform. If I give you 1, 2, 3 square, then you will find it difficult. But don't you know what is 50 square? Don't you know what is 10 square? So that is why I have used 50 here, so that you can find out the answer easily. Again, if you can see, there are two numbers. Now, can you tell me which is the closest number to both these numbers? Obviously, it is 80. Now, how can you write 79 in form of 80? 80 minus 1. How you can write 81 in the form of 80? 80 plus 1. 80 minus 1 is 79, 80 plus 1 is 81. Now I told you from the same property, which was a square minus b square equals to a plus b, a minus b. Simply what you have to do is 80 square minus 1 square. 80 square is 6400 minus 1, which equals to 6399. As simple as that. Now see, if you keep on multiplying these numbers, no doubt, even if your calculation is fast, then also you will take more time than this. So this was an easy way of multiplying two digits by using the property a square minus b square. There's another trick which will help you actually in finding the squares of number. So I want all of you to see here that we have two digit number 83 and we have to find the square of it. So the first step is find out the square of unit place and tens place. Unit place is the first place. Tens place is the second. 3 square is 9. 8 square is 64. Make sure that both the sides should be in 2 digit only, because here you have got 2 digit number. So you add 0 here, it becomes 2 digit. Now what next you will do? You will simply multiply these 3 numbers. 8, 3 and 2. 8 into 3, 24. 24 into 2 is 48. Now what you will do is, you will simply copy this last number here. You will simply copy this first number here. Now remaining these numbers, you will simply add. And how will you add? 0 plus 8 is 8. And 4 plus 4 is 8. So 83 square is 6889. That's a simple way. What you have to do is, this is a two digit number. First step is, write the square of this, write the square of this. Make sure that they both are in the same digit. Two digit, two digit. Then multiply 8, 3, 2. The three digits here, you get 48. 8 into 3, 24. 24 into 2 is 48. Then you will put this last number here, the first number here, and add the remaining digits. Like this, and the answer is going to be 6, 8, 8, 9. New that we will learn, let us follow the same step. 5 into 5, 25. 7 into 7, 49. We don't have to equal the numbers, because we see both are in two digits. Now, as I told you this step, you have to multiply these three numbers. 7 into 5 is 30. 30 into 2 is 70. Now, what was the last step? You will copy this number here, this number here. Now, how you will start adding? 4 plus 0 is 4. 7 plus 5 is 12, note down. So 12, 2 will come here and 1 will be carried. So 2 plus 1 will be 3. So 57 square is 3249. There's no change here, the change was only this carry that we took when we add 7 plus 5. Here 4 plus 4 was 0, so there was no carry here, but if here you get 7 plus 5, 12, 2 will be here, 1 will be carry, and 1 plus 2 was 3, so the answer is 324.
Now you all are supposed to solve and post the answers in the comment.